Hey guys, Finale J here, bringing you session number two of Mega Man Battle Network, and guess what? We got our controls figured out. Last time, we went and accepted a request of to help this guy to find his program for it, help Glide here. Find his program for his master or guy. So what we got? So we're just gonna get right into it. Okay, we got two Metars. Alright, we're just gonna drop some bombs on them. Just so you know, there is an order to these guys. It's always the closest to you, the second row, and then the last back row. The front row, back row, mid row, then back row. That's the order that you get. We got another shockwave chip, so I'm gonna grab that. Ooh, we got two shockwaves, so I'm gonna go and start replacing shotgun, because it offers the same thing. You don't have access to a lot of groundbreaking chips, and neither do your opponents. Okay, what we got here is what's called a turret. These guys, if you kill them, they will drop the met cannon chip, the normal cannon chip. What you'll see is that a lot of chips have an enemy that uses that chip, because as you may know, these battle chips are actually virus attack data that is converted to for human use. So what we're gonna do? So a good strategy for beating these guys is just to throw a bomb at them. Now their normal attack pattern is, I'll show you here. Boom, they'll drop that, and you got a little time to dodge it. But if they lock onto you, it'll hit you. The stronger versions of these guys, which come in red and blue, and then red varieties, they fire faster. So you have less time to react to it. And that, Mr. Data, we got Met Guard. Probably one of the most useful defensive chips in the game. There's very few defensive chips in this version. There we go. Well, what's this here? Get that first. World 3 pin, deleted, unlock. All others, be gone! The World 3 pin, huh? Mega Man, let's deal with that later. There's a connection to a World 3 thing! All the way up there, and we did, and nobody's tried to hack it before. Jeez, please, incompetence. Anywho, Met Guard is very interesting. We'll remember this area for later, you guys. So I'm going to show you if I can. Oh, I can't get. Anywho, I'm going to go and kill these cannons real quick. Just so I have fun. Met Guard brings up a shield if you hold. You have to hold down the chip attack button. There you go, shockwave here. And what if it gets hit? It reflects back a shockwave. I think it does like 30 damage or something. And yeah, so it basically nullifies a hit if it hits. If it's a shot type attack, or like something directional, not innate, like. Yeah, if you hit by anything, it'll knock throw it back as a shockwave attack. So we got a little bit of a snafu here. By the way, shockwave, most damaging. They're probably going to be your bread and butter for a while. And I should mention, you can only have five of the same chip in your library at the same time. By the way. Okay. And like I said, we got a cannon A. There's actually rare. Let's see here. What's this one? This one is guy's computer. So yeah, that's how you go to it. You go and, yep, I can now freely enter here. So what you need to do is I'll explain that actually later. Since we don't really need to right now. So what we got here, go cannon. Okay. Alright, so let's see here. Ooh, perfect. Got a bomb chip. I needed that. I had nothing else that would reach him. Boop. Alright, we got them down. Alright, I think I'm gonna leave the. I'm not gonna try and edit the fights out. Like, we got another Cuff G10. That's good. Alright, this guy is pretty cool. This guy is actually a merchant, he's a nut seller. So, what he's got, and if you actually bring up this, he's got Wide Sword, okay, which is. I think you need that for something for a chip combo, which I'll get to those later. We have Spreader, which basically it's a shotgun, but it hits all the enemy tiles if you hit in the middle. So basically hits a square around them. We have Recover 50, and we have a Cannon C. I'll explain Cannon C. Cannon C is the rare is if you get a high enough grade against those turret enemies, they will drop Cannon C. And you need Cannon C for a good reason. Now, we got here is, we got a power-up program, which, power-ups, which I'll go to the Mega Man menu. C under armor, you have attack, rapid, and charge. Those are your buster stats. Attack is how much damage you deal. You might do up to a max of 5 damage a shot. Rapid is how fast you attack. Charge is your classic Mega Man charge shot. You cannot charge at level 1, but if you get to level 2, you can charge, and it does double damage. This was and in later games, they actually added in functionality that it, depending on your armor or other things, they changed it with the double soul system in the later games, you would deal an extra effect depending on your element. So, anywho, so we got 700 Zenny, we got an HP memory. Let's buy this HP memory. So each time you buy one of these upgrades, it goes up. Anywho, if we go back to Mega Man, the HP memory gave us 20 HP. Each one gives you that much. Each HP memory gives you that much. So what we got here is... best bet is to use 2 shotguns. So I'm just going to lure Metal up here. And kill him with this. Boom. There we go. I'm going to take a little damage. You heal after every fight in this game, so don't worry about that. It's like Final Fantasy 13 in that respect. Oh, hey, a program. Where? Can't find my way home. Blood, come find me. Huh, I wonder if... I wonder if this is the program we needed to find. Lan, this must be the lost program. You're right, Mega Man. Go tell Glide. He's in Yai's portrait network, right? Okay. So, up here, this is... I don't have the address for it. To get the address, you actually have to, those things up here, they always take you to personal computers, which you can jack into normally through the real world. And, wow, I got the stupidest freaking comp. Yeah, I'm just gonna use shotguns twice. And then, and I'll shockwave it next turn. By the way, turrets only... if you get in front of them, that's the only time that they will actually activate their target lock-on. So, yeah, just so you know. So what we have here is it's an access to a personal computer or network. And we get another fight. So basically, ooh, good time to test out show you Met Guard. So okay, so watch this. And it passes through. I think maybe it doesn't reflect shotgun. Oh, I think that's the next game. Yeah, the next game that does that now, then. Metguard does at least notify damage. Maybe I'm wrong, I don't know. But, I just remember something like it. There is no Metguard in the next games. There's only a guard chip, which is different. And, yeah, another Metguard, which are actually pretty useful. Anywho. Gonna stand still so I don't trigger any more random battles. But yeah, this is an access to a person's computer. You get the network address by going to the person's computer in the real world by jacking into it directly, and you'll find a mystery data which gives you the address so you can access the network from the internet. Thing is though, there's actually Cannon B. Okay. Thing is though, is that if you do that, usually in the personal networks or the other unconnected ones, there's usually a special treasure. So, watch this is gonna be awesome. Boom, double shotgun. Bam. Shotgun rain. Oh, nice. That's actually a really rare, we got Shockwave C, which is actually going to be a little bit easier to use. And where is the X panel? I want to get rid of that. Yes. Okay. So we got to go talk to Glide. Bad at explaining and talking at the same time.